The clock is ticking. We just have a few more months until the November election. So what I'd like is for each panelist to let us know what is the one call to action that you would like each of us to know about so that everyone can make a difference.
You have to call every representative you have in Congress and tell them that they must allocate federal funds for elections to make sure that every eligible American will be able to cast a ballot safely in November, and that our right to vote does not have to butt against our right to be safe and healthy.
My key call to action as the Managing Counsel for Election Protection at the Lawyers Committee is to ask that people volunteer, if not for election protection, which I hope they do, since we recruit both legal volunteers and grassroots and other volunteers, and there's plenty of opportunities to volunteer for election protection. There's other ways to help the election process in your states and in your local jurisdictions, including volunteering to be poll workers, including volunteering to monitor election meetings by boards of elections to see what's happening on the ground and to advocate for better elections and better administration of elections. So there's many opportunities that people have who have an interest in improving elections to volunteer, either with groups that do voter registration or election protection or with the election office in your locality, and to monitor what's happening both in the local jurisdictions as well as in the state legislatures to make voting better for everyone.
My number one call to action for this election would be make sure that you yourself have requested an absentee ballot so you can vote by mail, and make sure that everyone else you know has done the same.
My call to action is simple. Go to justiceaid.org, find the donate button, hit it, give what you're able, knowing that dollar for dollar of what you donate will go to Electoral Protection 866-R-VOTE, the campaign of the Lawyers Committee for Civil Rights under law. And every dollar that you give will be matched up to $100,000 by the Board of Justice Aid. So we hope to raise $200,000 for election protection this spring. Justice Aid uses the arts to raise money for civil rights organizations. And we had lined up for election protection a concert May 18th at City Winery, following a forum at Riverside Church. And in the fall, concerts featuring Mavis Staples at the Lincoln Theater, along with a Civic Life Project film festival to bring young people's voices to issues that matter to young people in a format that will encourage young people to vote, particularly young people of color who are particularly disenfranchised. We are turning all that material into virtual content and will endeavor to broadcast it. Please sign on to justiceaid.org, not only to donate so we can support election protection, but to stay tuned to coming attractions where you will find the artists and other information about the events we're producing.
My number one call to action, what I'm hearing tonight is that to get out the vote, we need to get out the truth. Of course, elections are about winning. But elections also are about fairness, about integrity, and about equality. Elections are about the future we want for our children and for their children, and the future we should want for all of America's children. Let's use our resources, and for some of us, yes, let's use the power and privilege of a Harvard education to get the truth out. The truth about the need for mail-in ballots, about the unfairness, irrationality, and racism of many ID laws, and about the partisan cruelty of making people, mostly people of color, choose between exercising the franchise and risking exposure to COVID-19. To get the vote out, people of integrity with resources and power and privilege, the kinds of power and privilege present in this room tonight, need to get out the truth. Do this in any way you can. By writing op-eds, by sending letters to the editor, by engaging with social media, and by talking with people who might not be your friends. And maybe, just maybe, we'll be able to save our democracy. The stakes have never been higher.